Good evening. The racing industry is in shock tonight after a favourite son lost his life in a fall. Group 1 winner Dean Holland, a father of four, came off his mount as he entered the final straight at Donald. Nat Ioannidis has the latest.
Entering the straight at the Donald Racecourse, leading jockey Dean Holland was thrown from his mount.
Headingley came down at the top of the home straight. Time to Rumble went over the top.
All further races were cancelled as the 34-year-old was treated by paramedics. An air ambulance was dispatched, but Holland was pronounced dead at the scene.
He could ride at a lightweight, a very popular rider, and the industry will be a very sad place today to learn that news.
The South Australian leaves behind his wife Lucy and four children under the age of five.
We had a baby, that's the fourth in 4 years, so she's done a big job, and that's the fourth and last. Ready to make some money and buy some nappies.
Tributes for the leading jockey have been swift. Trainer Peter Moody posted, "Thoughts and prayers to Lucy and his beautiful young family. Way too soon, RIP young man." Holland is a two-time Group 1 winning jockey. His most recent success came in the prestigious Newmarket Handicap last month.
But it's the filly In Secret holding on. In Secret won the Newmarket.
He was given the ride on In Secret after Jamie Carr was seriously concussed in a fall earlier in the day. Melbourne Cup winning jockey Craig Williams broke his collarbone in the same incident.
The last thing I wanted to do was carry on today, win, lose or draw. It's very unfortunate what happened to Jamie and Willow, and my thought goes out to them. I'm just the lucky one that was able to ride light today.
Last month, jockey Ethan Brown suffered life-threatening injuries after falling in the Australian Guineas. Weeks later, Teo Nugent fractured his neck in a separate fall at Moonee Valley.
It's one of the most dangerous sports known to mankind, but it's driven by the love of wanting to do it by the boys and girls, and to have such a sad outcome is tragic.
Fellow jockey Alana Kelly was also brought down in the incident at Donald, but walked away from the fall. Both horses were unharmed.
And Nat is at Racing Victoria headquarters tonight. Nat, what more do we know about the investigation into this tragedy?
Pete, police have confirmed they will be preparing a report for the coroner, and WorkSafe is also investigating the incident that led to the death of Dean Holland today, or this afternoon, I should say. Now, racing tomorrow will be cancelled at Moe and Flemington in honour of the 34-year-old and his death today. Racing Victoria has released a statement extending their condolences to the Holland family. In that statement, Chief Executive Andrew Jones said that they are so saddened by the passing of Dean, everyone from Racing Victoria and the sport nationally, and it is a sobering reminder of the immense bravery of all our riders. Now, the racing fraternity, the racing community is a very close-knit one. No doubt they will be coming to death together tonight and mourning the loss of Dean Holland. Anybody who is struggling has been urged to call Stable Line for support. Pete.
Thank you so much, Nat Ioannidis.